What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. As requested by many of you, today we'll be working on one of the most important aspects of bodyweight training, and that is scapula stability. We'll be going over the basic scapula movements, the most useful exercises for calisthenics purposes, and we'll put it all together into a full workout that you can follow along with me. You will have options for each movement to do it on bars, rings, with bands, or with zero equipment, so you can do this workout anywhere you like and explore different variations every time you choose. You will also have modifications for each exercise, so you can tailor it to your own level. The full workout only lasts around 7 minutes, so no excuses to get that scapula girdle, the strongest it's ever been. So without further ado, let's get to the video. Before we start, it is important that we get familiar with the basic movements of the scapula thoracic joint so we're able to apply them to the movements we're about to do. I recommend that you practice this standing before you attempt the workout. So in short, we have protraction, shoulders move forward and scapula moves away from the spine. Retraction, shoulders move back and scapulas move towards the spine. Elevation, shoulders move up and scapula move upwardly. Depression, shoulders press down and scapulas move down. With that out of the way, the following routine is divided into five main blocks. For block one, we have horizontal patterns with two exercises. Block two, we have vertical patterns, two exercises. Block three, we're focusing on the rotator cuff with one exercise. Block four is traps focus with one exercise. And finally, block five is an optional block, full body stability with one exercise. I would like to talk as little as possible throughout the follow-along routine, so let's quickly go over the exercises and the variations so you can pick the right one for you. For block one, we'll be doing two exercises. First, scapula push-ups. The three variations here from easy to hard are on quadruped, on plank, and one-arm plank. Here we move from full protraction to full retraction, keeping the depression throughout the entire movement. Next, on block one, we have scapula rows. This can be done on a low bar or rings, and adjust the intensity by increasing or decreasing the inclination. Alternatively, for a zero equipment option, do scapular retractions on floor to work on similar muscles. Here we move from full retraction to a slight protraction, keeping the depression. For block two, we'll be doing again two exercises. First, scapula pull-ups, also known as active to passive hang, can be done on a pull-up bar with feet assisted, two hands, or one hand. And for zero equipment option, we can do prone swimmers to still activate the lats to some degree while building shoulder mobility and stability. Here we move from elevation to depression. Second exercise is scapula shrugs. For the easiest progression, do it on pike, next elevated pike, and finally chest to wall handstand shrugs. Here we move from elevation to depression. For block three, we switch gears now to focus on the rotator cuff muscles with one exercise, which is famous for a reason, face pulls. Can be done on rings for a higher intensity and inclination can be adjusted for all levels. Can also be done with bands or alternatively with our equipment, we would use prone W raises. Here it's a combination of movements, but as a main focus, we want to drive the elbows back in line with the shoulders and hands behind the elbow while fully retracting the scapulas. For block four, we're focusing on the traps, especially the mid-lower region, which doesn't tend to get enough attention. We're doing T raises. Again, can be done on rings, known as reverse flies, and also with bands. And for home version, we would do prone T raises. Full depression while we raise the arms by our side and allow our scapulas to naturally retract. Finally, for block five, as an optional bonus, we are doing unstable elbow plank. You can do it on a yoga ball or anything unstable, or you can use rings for plank on arms. And if you don't have anything around, balancing elbow plank is a great option. Just make sure to do both sides equally. With the instructor covered, we're gonna be going for 40 seconds on each exercise with 20 second break in a circuit style fashion for a total of a 7 minute workout. My picks for today's workout are going to be scapula push-ups on plank, scapula rows on rings, scapula pull-ups on bar, scapula shrugs on chest to wall handstand, face pulls on rings, T raises on floor, and on a stable plank on a yoga ball. Now in the screen, you will see the full routine with all the variations and modifications, so feel free to screenshot it for future reference or download the free PDF on the description. Pick the right variation for you, and I'll see you on the follow along. Let's go! All right, family, ready? Whether you're ready or not, we're gonna begin in 10 seconds. We begin with the scapula push-ups, so choose your variation. We begin in 7. I'm gonna set up in plank. 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Retract, protract, keep the depression, that's for 1, Let's keep going.
Is the voice of reason.
Try to keep a neutral spine, so don't round on the top. Make the movement only come from the shoulder blades and hold 1 second on each position. Retraction, protraction. Retraction, protraction. Stay with me, we're almost there. And break. We got 20 seconds. Let's go to the scapular rows and can be done on rings or on a low bar, or you can choose to do the floor version. We begin in 8 seconds. So begin sitting up, arms fully, fully straight, elbows locked, body line intact. And we start. Arms fully straight, retract, hold, release to neutral. That's for one. Let's keep going. Seconds left. If you find yourself bending the arms, adjust the intensity. The only movements should be from the upper traps, the rhomboids, creating that retraction. Make sure to also keep a strong depression and don't allow your shoulders to elevate. Three, last rep, make it count. One, and break. Now we go to the pull-up bar to work on scapula depression, especially good for pull-ups. We begin in 10 seconds. Again, you can do feet assisted. You can do it on the bar, you can do it on rings, or you can do the version on the floor. Beginning three, two, one, throw the bar, deep press, elevate, shoulders touches the ear, hold for 1 second, repeat, make every rep count. Want a little more, you can deep press and lean back and retract and then release, or you can do it on one single arm. And break. Moving on now to the similar movement of the scapula, but now focusing on the elevation rather than the depression. I'm gonna do it on chest wall, hands and hold, do it on pike or elevated pike if that's the level for you. Begin setting up. And let's go. Hand shoulder width ideally. Find the body line, find the handstand first. Deep press, full elevation, touch the shoulders towards the ears, and repeat. Break. We know now to the rings. Now switching gears to the rotator cuff muscles. I'm gonna be doing face pulls here on the rings. Again, you can do it on the floor version or the band version as well. We begin in three, two, one. Let's go. Elbow in line with the shoulder. Wrist ideally behind the shoulder. That is for one. Let's go for as many as we can. Let's go. That hole at the top, super, super important for mind-muscle connection. Any scapula work, you wanna be doing it as slow as possible. Quality over quantity all day long. 7 seconds left. And break. Next, now we go to the floor. Well, I go to the floor. You can do it on rings for reverse flies. I just really, really enjoy prone T raises. We'll be going in 7 seconds. So set up in the floor or on the rings. Hands abducted at 90 degrees. Forehead down. External rotate the shoulders. Deep press and raise the arms. Hold. Release down.
Raise, hold, release down. Let's keep going for the time remaining. Pay attention to my thumb here, as I'm going to the outside, so we create as much external rotation of the shoulder as possible. So avoid this and always go for this. And break. Finishing off with unstable plank. I'm gonna be doing it on the ball. Hopefully I can stay here for the 40 seconds that we have. Again, you can do it on rings or choose any variation, anything on a stable that you can put yourself in. 3, 2, 1. Full protraction on any variation. Posterior pelvic tilt. Create a body line that will be carried over to other skills. Find your balance, find your breath, find one point of stillness of your gaze so you can stay in balance as much as possible. Keep the core braced and tight. 15 seconds left. If you want an extra challenge, you can close your eyes. I'm not closing my eyes, so don't look at me. But if you're closing your eyes, you're not looking at me. But 3, 2, 1, and break. Break, and we're done. Let me catch my breath. And there you have it, guys. A complete stability workout that you can do 2 to 3 times per week, ideally. You can do just one round at the beginning of your workouts for a complete warm-up, or you can also do it at the end of your workouts, 2 to 3 sets, or even as a standalone workout, which will be 21 minutes or 30 minutes if you do a 3 to 4 rounds. With that being said, guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, share, subscribe, comment down below what else we'd like to see on this channel. Next to me, you have the winners from last week's giveaway. And you guys just won 3 months for free as a premium membership to the SM Academy, full access to an entire library of courses, workout programs, or individual moves so you can create your own workouts, or HIIT section, or mindfulness and meditation section, or calisthenics skill sections, and mobility and flexibility protocol section, or primal element section, or hybrid home workout experience so you can work out at home, and basically everything that is the universe of the SM Academy. Remember that we post every Thursday at 12 p.m. EST, and if you come within the first 60 minutes of the video, you get a chance to win the giveaway. With that being said, guys, I'll see you all next week. Much love. Woo! Yeah! Giveaway. And you guys just won 3 months for free as a premium membership.